Hello and welcome to Tutorials Point. In this session, we'll be learning about CSS methods. First one is .css method. Using .css method, we can either set the CSS properties or we can either get the CSS properties present in that element. Next is width and height method. Using width and height method, we can either set the width and height of that element or we can get the height of that element or same width. Next is inner height and inner width. Using inner height and inner width, it returns the height and width of that element, and similarly we can set the height and width of element but it includes padding as well. Next is outer height and outer width. Using outer height and outer width, we can set or return the height of and width of that element, but in this case it includes padding as well as borders. Next is offset. Using offset, we return the X position and Y position of the element with respect to the screen. It returns the coordinates of that element. Let's see all these functions in practical.
In our web page, we have heading as CSS methods. We have a div having some background color and text as this is a div. Let's say this an output. So here is our web page containing CSS methods as heading and a div which contains this is a div as text with background color as green. We have included the jQuery from code.jquery.com CDN. In our script tag, we have a variable red CSS with $div.css background color. .css background color will return the value of this background color to us. So we are using .css method to get the value of background color from this div. Let's see the output of this in our log. So you can see we have output as RGB 0 to 550, which is nothing but green color. Now, uncommenting this will set the height of div to 100 pixels because we are using .css method and we are passing height, 100 pixels here. Let's see the output. When I refresh the page, we can see the height of div is changed to 100 pixels. Now, here we have written another .css method which tries to change many CSS properties at once, like width is set to 300 pixels, font size is set to 40 pixels, and padding is set to 20 pixels. So this should modify the shape and size of our div plus the font size of our text. When I refresh the page, I can see the width of div is reduced to 300 pixels, the font size of text is increased, and we have a padding around the text. So this is how we can add multiple CSS properties at once using .css method. Let's see .width method in action. When we use .width 500 pixels, we should see that the width of div should increase to 500 pixels from 300 pixels. Refreshing this, we can see that width of the div is increased. Similarly, here we have a variable getHeight which we are using to store the value of $div.height. So $div.height should return us the value of height of this div. I'll uncomment this log and let's see the output here. When I refresh the page, I get the height as 100. So the height of div is 100. Let's see the inner height of the div. Similarly, like we obtained height, we are using inner height method to obtain the inner height. We get the output as 140. That's because inner height includes padding as well in consideration. Now we're using .offset method to get the coordinates of our div. That is, we are obtaining the position of our div from top and left. When I refresh the page, I get offset values as 79.875 and left 8. So this div is 79.875 distance from top and 8 from left. This is how offset works. Now we are setting the offset values through our script. We are setting top equal to 55 and left equals to 25. So this should move our div a bit. So we can see that the position of our div has changed from our previous position. So this is how CSS methods work. Thank you.